Hey guys, Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Right before this, you just saw this brand new dog that just came in. Taiga just came in from New Jersey. Very leash reactive, pretty pushy, snotty, bratty. Big sized dog, drags its owner all over the place. So we went from the assessment room, which you saw the video on, and we gave it to Spencer, one of our trainers, and then Spencer put it back in his kennel. This is only 5 minutes later. I'm going to work with him for the very first time. So I want to show you what we do with dogs the very first time. Now, we do different things with different types of dogs. If he was an aggressive dog, we'd be doing something different. If he was a shy, nervous dog, we'd be doing something different. But this is a snotty, bratty dog. You'll notice how quiet he is right now. Like, listen. There's 12 dogs in his kennel right now. You hear quietness. It's not because they're tired, it's because they're quiet. But then you're gonna get a dog like this, he doesn't understand what quiet in a kennel means. So watch what we do for the very first time. The first thing I'm gonna do is put a training collar on him. I'm gonna make sure this is sized right. So we'll use some extra links. First conversation we are going to have. So you come into my kennel, all tough. You think you own the place. You're barking when you want to. You're pulling staff around when you want to. You're going up to all the other kennels when you want to. You're going over to our food bins. You know, like checking out the buffet. So we got to let you know. You know what? Those aren't the rules here. You're here for rehabilitation. First thing I've got to do is I've got to get a prong collar on and a training collar. We got to get this dog to do a default waiting at the kennel. Dogs like this usually probably burst out of their kennel. I open up the door. Actually, that's really good. Let's say he pushed his way out the door. I would just do that. And if I, even if I hit him in the face, it doesn't hurt. I'm not trying to hurt the dog. But he's got to know kennels are not for rushing out of. I need to create a safe environment. Could you imagine if I opened up this door like this and the dog came racing out and like ran over and fence fight with another dog? It would be horrific. And how about another dog that's bigger that we're rehabilitating? It's not fair to that dog. Open up the door. Now we always reach in like that. Did you notice where my head was? When I was putting that on, my collar and leash are ready. I go underneath the dog's head. Look, he can't bite my head. Leash is on, but I'm gonna close the door again out. I open up the door. Let's go. Comes out like a rocket, looks like now. Default sit. Notice how I'm not going to talk to this dog. I'm going to talk to you guys. Now we want to walk him up to the first threshold. You see all this energy in here? default waiting at doors. Remember, I haven't talked to this dog yet. So far, I've gotten him to wait in his kennel and come out on command. Now, open up the door. It's the quickness. I've shown that in different videos. I'm not yanking him back, I'm giving him a quick bit of information. Notice how the leash is not wrapped around my hands. I'm actually holding the leash very gentle. One more time. I'd like him to sit down, but that wasn't bad. And then, let's go. The next threshold. A little bit firmer. He tried to be a little bit pushy with me. Now, some folks might not see pushy, bratty behavior in this dog. They might just see like an excited dog. I see pushy, bratty behavior. Also, you can tell from the video that I played at the beginning of this, his behavior around other dogs. Not bad. I'm going to want to improve that, but not bad. So, nice eye contact. He's being very respectful of me right now. I can walk around him any way I want. He's not moving, all right? Big difference between this behavior and out there. Again, I just grabbed the leash of this dog. This is the first time I've worked with this dog. This is welcome to Sally Canine Training Kennel Life. A lot of folks ask us, like, how do you get the dogs to be quiet in their kennels right away? Believe it or not, this helps them being quiet in their kennel.
Watch how he goes to immediately sniff the ground, and I don't let him. A very, very powerful conversation right there. Again, sets the tone.
He wants to sniff things. He's not allowed to sniff things. Good. And then what I'll do is, I will continue out. Here's another good example. Here's some of our daycare dogs. So we've got 5 dogs left from daycare here right now. Again, no, you can't sniff that dog. Why? Because when you're sniffing that dog, you're not paying attention to me. So you should be able to walk past these dogs. Mind your own business. This isn't a buffet. So this is training. We don't even have to go out to the training room. Great.
Hey guys, it's Jeff. Just doing a structured walk with 4 dogs. We just finished up about a 3-mile walk. One of the dogs I've got with me is Gellman. The dog that came in yesterday, highly leash reactive towards other dogs. And there he is right now. So we have 2 client dogs. Can we see that? There he is right there. The only golden dog that's there. So I got 2 client dogs, 2 of my dogs. They got golden, the yellow lab is not, is unneutered, which doesn't make a difference. He's doing great. This is his first day of training. He did a little bit of leadership stuff yesterday, and this is his first official walk. And I immediately threw him into a pack of dogs. When we come to a stop, I expect all dogs to be sitting properly, waiting for their next thing. So when I stop, they automatically sit. And the new dog just had to get a little bit of leash pressure to figure that out. Madly in love with you guys. Jeff of Solid Canine Training. Just checking in with you.
Sit down. Are you here?
Good. Oh, here. Good job. All right. Down. Good. Great. Good job. Down.
Good.
No. Down. So also I'm going right to correction mode with this dog. Why? The dog gets it. That is why. Plus the owner's done a little bit of training, so the dog understands the concept of training. So the dog has all the pieces, but doesn't know how to put the puzzle together. So we've got this high drive dog that is just blows commands off. He's terrible with dogs, he's highly leash reactive. You saw the video of this dog doing a four dog pack walk with me. You saw this dog around a bunch of dogs. So we're eliminating a lot of issues. But this dog right now is so going to be so good. After 3 weeks, this dog's going to be incredible. Right? Heel. Down. Good. Tiger here. Good job, buddy. Nope, here. Sit. Look at that. Down. Good. Break. Good job, buddy. Heel. Down. Good. So now I'm going to find weaknesses. I gotta find holes in the training. I gotta find weaknesses where I can make this dog stronger. Ugh. It's my back. My back's doing better. No. Hot. Down. Weakness. So we proofed that. So, it might have been too much. Remember, this is day one of obedience training with this dog. Okay? Day one.
On command. Everybody always asks me about Calm on Command. Calm on Command is pretty much all of my training put together that creates a calm dog. So this is an interesting thing. This dog has been here for 24 hours. And watch, look at it struggle. Just keep the camera on this dog right now. Look at it struggle. All right, why is this dog struggling? It's struggling because it has to stay in a down for as long as I tell it to. And it's having a really hard time with non-negotiable down. It doesn't want to be doing this. It wants to be walking around. Every time Lauren, who's filming right now, wants to stand up and walk across to get a cup of coffee or a drink or to take her dog out, it wants to get up and follow her. It wants to be, you know, doing something adrenalized. It doesn't know how to relax. Look at this dog struggle. It's shaking. It's panting. It's stressed, and guess what it has to do? All it has to do is do nothing. So what am I training this dog to do right now? Today we did a structured walk, we did dog socialization, we did remote collar training, leash training, but now we're doing duration work. So this dog struggles. He rocked at everything else. He struggles on this. It's really interesting to see this dog. The dog is detoxing. So imagine if you're on heroin and all of a sudden you don't get your heroin for the day. This is the dog trying to get off heroin right now.